Hi everyone, this is Marissa from Knowledge Scroll, and in today's brief video for Formula Fridays, I will be going through with you what is a quadratic function and how to use the quadratic formula to solve for its roots. So, first thing you should know is any equation that has the general formula ax squared plus bx plus c is called a quadratic equation, where a, b, and c are constants, but a can't be zero. Let us look at some examples of the quadratic equations and see if we can identify the values of a, b, and c. The first one is x squared plus 2x take away 5. A, in this case, is equal to 1 even though it is not written, it is implied. B is equal to 2. And for the last one, you have to be very careful with this because c is equal to negative 5 as the sign and the number go together. In the second one, we have 3x squared take away 4x. A, in this case, is 3. B is negative 4. And since there is no c term, we will leave it as 0. In the last one, x squared only has a value for the a term, which is again 1. B and c are 0. Now that this is out of the way, let's move on to something called the quadratic formula. In exams, you are sometimes asked to solve for the values of x, which are called the roots or the solutions of the quadratic equation. These can be calculated using this formula shown below. I know it looks intimidating, but it's actually quite easy to use, and we will try to do that now. We're going to solve x squared plus 3x take away 4 using the formula. Again, identify your values for a, b, and c, and let's plug them into the formula. A is 1, B is 3, and C is negative 4. So the formula now becomes negative 3 plus or minus the square root of 3 squared minus 4 multiplied by 1 multiplied by negative 4. And this is all divided by 2 multiplied by 1. Remember to solve the section under the square root first. 3 squared is 9, and negative 4 multiplied by 1 multiplied by negative 4 is positive 16. This can be further simplified into this. And finally, x is now equal to negative 3 plus or minus 5 divided by 2. This is where it gets interesting. Since you have a plus or minus sign, this formula can produce two answers. Let us start with the plus sign first. X is equal to negative 3 plus 5 divided by 2, which is 2 divided by 2. Therefore, x equals to 1. Or, using the negative sign, x is equal to negative 3 minus 5 divided by 2, which is negative 8 divided by 2. Therefore, x equals to negative 4. So, our answers are x equal to 1 and x equal to negative 4. Now that we have learned about the quadratic equation and how to use the quadratic formula, here are some questions for you to try. Remember, with any formula, your answer can be a decimal value, and the standard is to put your answers to two decimal places. I hope you enjoyed today's video. We thank you for watching. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And we will see you soon in our next video.